Well, getting that knock on the door or maybe a phone call in the middle of the night, it's every parent's worst nightmare. And unfortunately, that nightmare became a reality for Kerrie Warne. And she's joining us this morning to talk more about the dangers of driving drunk, along with Matt Uhles, who's with the Clayton Sleep Institute. Good morning to both of you.
Good morning.
And Kerrie, we'll start with you. What happened with your son? I know this was back in 2010.
So it was the last Friday of his spring break, and he had spent that day, that afternoon, with a couple of his friends at a cheerleading competition. And so they were on their way home. They dropped off their first friend, and him and his second friend got in the car, got on the interstate to head for home. And at approximately 2:50 in the afternoon, his car left the interstate and went down the embankment. And according to the eyewitnesses, it flipped 4 to 5 times before it came to rest at the tree. And so drugs, alcohol, reckless driving were all ruled out. In fact, we knew it was a fall asleep crash because he had his friend with him. I'm happy to say his friend walked away from that accident with only minor injuries, but obviously my son did not.
And Tyler was 18 at the
18,
time?
18, senior in high school.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah.
And this is prevention week for drowsy driving this week. And Matt, I mean, what are some things that parents can look for in their children?
Well, it's not just our kids, it's us as well. A big part is just not getting enough sleep each night. That can lead us to be sleepy and tired. Keeping an inconsistent schedule, flipping it during the week and then on the weekends. But really, signs are if your kids are cranky and crabby, and there's no really need to. Oftentimes, not getting enough sleep can affect mood, grade performance, if they're coming home and they're just a little lethargic. Not really responsive after school, and burning the candle at both ends can all result in being too sleepy.
You talk about teens being drowsy. I think it was only 20% are getting the amount of sleep that they should be getting, and men are more likely than women to actually drive drowsy and to get in a fatal accident.
Right. So one of the scariest statistics I've ever heard is 1 out of 5 high school seniors admit to driving drowsy once a week.
That is frightening.
Mm-hmm.
And Kerrie, you're out educating. You guys travel the country together.
Yes.
And you've created your own website.
Yes.
Yeah.
So we founded a not-for-profit because I was, I got so mad.
Yeah.
It's funny because in our real jobs, he'd come in to do a lunch and learn, and on sleep apnea, and there's a video out there with a cab driver who falls asleep, and so I started to do some research, and my son was the perfect statistic, and there's so much information available about our young adults. So he was 18. That 2 to 4 window in the afternoon is the second most likely time to be involved in a drowsy driving accident. He was very active. He worked. He was in sports. He went to high school. You know, he's getting ready to graduate. So he could have been the poster child, but I knew nothing about it. I had no idea to educate him about it. And so I called Matt, really mad, and that's sort of how it happened, and said, why didn't I know? And he said, Kerrie, I've been trying to get into the schools and educate people, but kids don't care about science, you know? I don't get back. He said, what I need is a story, and that's sort of how we founded Tired, because it's so much more than just my son's story. He's one of thousands of kids who doesn't make their graduation or who doesn't get to go to college or their senior prom. And so I wanted a very holistic approach where it wasn't just me telling my story, but that we were providing education to prevent these crashes and these deaths, because they are preventable through education. You think about, MAD, and so people still drive drunk, but it's significantly reduced in distracted driving. We're all educated about that. But this is something that, you know, when we go in the schools, the kids tell us all the time, we've never heard about this. Nobody's ever told us about this. And as a parent, nobody had ever mentioned that to me. We never thought about it. It was long-haul truck drivers, shift workers, airplane pilots. That's what I thought of. Not my teenage kid coming home from school or coming home in the middle of the day at 2:50 in the afternoon.
Thank you both for being with us this morning. I think you're getting mad is probably saving some lives out there, Kerrie.
You.
Yeah, absolutely. For more information on Tyler raising education awareness for driving drowsy, head to the STL Moms tab. We'll link you to that, and also the Clayton Sleep Institute. John and Randy.